Hey, what's up, gang? Brian here, Brian's Lawn Maintenance. Hey, trust you guys are doing well. Hey, a lot of you guys have been asking a lot of questions about the trailer. I know I've done kind of like a short unboxing, not really an unboxing, just kind of introducing it to you video. I've done the trailer kind of setup video. A lot of you guys still have questions about the trailer in general, like pricing, different things like that. Let me give you guys just some ideas. Do me a big favor, by the way. I really want to maybe show other companies how our channel does make some influencing as a video influencer and a social influencer. If you guys are in the market for SureTrack trailers or you pick anything up like this, leave a comment down below. I'd love to know your thoughts if you guys are in the market for a SureTrack. I wanted to maybe just go over some of the trailer components, some of the upgrade options, some of the pricing. As you guys see, I am an honorary SureTrack spokesperson today. This video is not endorsed by SureTrack. In fact, they'll probably tell me to pull it down. No, I'm just kidding. But let me just have some fun with you guys. Again, I'm not the authority here by any means, but I'll tell you guys as a friend, I've looked at a lot of trailers over the last 3 or 4 years. I did not just buy the trailer because we have a YouTube channel and I wanted to somehow, like, you know, get famous with it or anything like that. Guys, I've been in the market for a new enclosed trailer for probably 3 years. Honestly, same thing with my truck. I'm not saying I'm buying a new truck this fall by any means, but I've been looking at new trucks for about 3 years as well. I'm one of those people, man. I just like knowing my options. I like knowing the details. I want to run the numbers and make sure that what I'm buying makes the most sense for me. I do have that kind of detailed personality, so sometimes I overthink things, but let me give you guys just some of my thoughts about the trailer if you guys are in the market. I know this is probably the Rolls Royce of trailers, no doubt about it. There's a couple different options you can get. I'll go over those for you, maybe give you a walkthrough, and maybe give you guys my mindset with the trailer as well, so you guys kind of know what you're looking at. All right, now one of the reasons I wanted to go with SureTrack, and I'm telling you guys like a friend, I would rather buy a more expensive product from somebody I know than a product from somebody that I don't know. I'm sure a lot of you guys are like that. Number two, I like supporting local businesses. Our dealer is Kelly and Sons Trailer over in Carlton, Michigan, and those guys are just fantastic people. In fact, I was trying to get some more information to do this video from you guys with talking to their son Steve, and Steve and Sue and those guys over at Kelly and Sons in Carlton, Michigan, seriously some of the coolest people I've ever met. In fact, so many of you guys have mentioned in comments and emails and Instagram that you guys have purchased from them before. So many guys around here have used them and know of them. So Kelly and Sons Trailers in Carlton, Michigan, that's where I got mine. Again, they are the ones that support the local lawn and landscape show where I live, the MGIA, and you know, I'm really thankful for that. Honestly, I never probably would have picked up a utility trailer or an enclosed trailer from them if they didn't come to that show, because they were just the people that were there. They were the featured trailer vendor. So back then, I didn't really know too much about SureTrack. To me, it was just another trailer name. I didn't really know anything about them, but what I've come to learn is that they really pride themselves on how they make their product. They really pride themselves on being kind of the industry standard, the compliance they do with their trailers, the quality of build they do with their trailers, and honestly, the options and the upgrades you can do with your trailers, okay? So let me give you guys just some ideas. The pricing here, I'm not 100% accurate on all of it for darn sure. I'm not making these numbers up. I'm just trying to remember what I paid. I don't have any paperwork in front of me. I don't have a sell sheet in front of me. I wish I did. But let me give you guys just the overview of the trailer. Let me give you guys some of the options you may consider. And then I'll just kind of maybe give you guys my mindset about why I didn't do certain things and why I got other things, okay? So first off, guys, let's just do the quick walk around. And by the way, I'm at where I store it. It's extremely windy out today. It always is when I decide to do a video, right? But this one right here, you got the 8.5 by 16. You've got the tandem axle. You've got the 7,000 pound torsion axles here. Let's see, we got the side RV door. You got the two vents on top. They're gonna be right there. It's kind of hard to see because they're blending in with the sky. We have the drop back jack on it. Now this guy right here allows you to still put down your tailgate if you have a truck or a dump truck. I really like that feature. I think that's an upgrade. Let's see what else. We got the 2x6 tubed frame all the way through this thing. All right, guys, a lot of people, they don't have the center beam going through on their trailers. And I'm not sure if that's called the C design. It probably is the A design, I think they call it. Again, I'm not trying to sound more intelligent than I am with what I know about the trailers, but there are certain reasons trailers cost more done right. This one right here, it has the coupler on it. Now a lot of you guys know of like the loop style coupler that's good for a dump truck. Me personally, I was never really thinking about ever getting into landscaping. I'm still not. I love landscaping now, but I'm just not interested in getting that little loop coupler that goes around the front. I'm not sure if that is an option. I'm sure it is. Like, what I mean is it costs more. I'm sure it does. And then if I'm not mistaken, not only did it have the loop style coupler, but it also had the ability to adjust on the ones that were at the yard for demo as their kind of show trailer. Another thing I really like about this trailer is, I'm not sure if you guys can see this, but this pin, all I do is pull it out on the other side. And then this piece right here, I can drop it down, and then you use the jack to just shimmy it up the 2 or 3 inches that you need to get it off the coupler. So that's a really cool feature. Instead, obviously, if you guys have a utility trailer, you literally have to spin this about, gosh, I don't know, man, for 60 seconds straight just to get that 13 inches, 14 inches of vertical lift to get it off the hitch and to get the jack all the way down. So I like the fact that I can just drop it really quick. I get probably 10 inches there, and then all I have to do is about 4 or 5 spins on the handle to get up the coupler, and boom, the trailer's off the rack. You can't beat that, guys. Now, this one has the rounded top. You have the Euro style lighting, as you guys can see. That's these little LEDs up here. Now, guys, I'm telling you like a friend, when you're coming in late night or early in the morning, those things just absolutely pop. You've got the chrome diamond plating on the front. You got the chrome accent pieces. You got the 2-inch chrome trim. What I did right here, by the way, maybe SureTrack can learn a little bit from this video. This right here is a bumper. I added that on. It was like $4. One of the reasons I picked it up was because the RV door was catching the wind. And as you guys can see already, I have 2 little dimples here, and honestly, that really pisses me off. There's nothing I can really do about it now, but those were on the trailer within the first week. The side RV door just smacks it as hard as you can imagine. Yes, there is a little bracket here that, you know, you can keep the door clamped, but when we're going from house to house, I'm not going to be, you know, clamping the door. And as you guys can imagine, I don't re-rack the trimmer or the blower every time. When we're going house to house, this is what the trailer looks like. We just grab the blowers. Normally I have a trimmer sitting right here or an edger sitting right here. And my guys just rip that stuff in and out. We grab the blower, we throw it back in. Boom, we're good to go, and we're on to the next lawn. So when we're opening up those trailers and it's a windy day, boom, those things just smash. So when I have this, I try to get it as close as I can. That way we have the most amount of distance away from the wall with those brackets. Now, if it gets really windy, and if I really push it, you guys can see that on a good swing, it can still hit the door. But honestly, it's a lot less likely to be such an impactful hit to where it's gonna hit through this metal wall, which, you know, it is what it is. I'm not really too mad about it. You just move on, right? It's got the extra safety latch, you know, so when you are going anywhere on the roads, anytime we leave a subdivision, we always throw it back on. I know it clips, the door clips pretty good, but you know, I like a little bit extra security. We have had it where we've seen the RV door swing open when we're on the road, going from house to house. This one here, it has the side vents, as you guys can see. A lot of great cross breeze going through the trailer. And again, just another quick walk around, man. I know you guys really appreciated the video. Let me just close up the door really quick. You can do that with one hand, guys. The spring assist is really, really nice. You got the 5 bumpers up here that lay on the ground. Obviously, we're wearing those out a little bit, but those last for a while. Up on top, you got the LED lighting, the Euro style lighting. All right, pretty cool. And again, you have the heavy duty hitches. Now, this was something that was definitely a selling point. Most guys only came with about 3 or 4 hinges on their trailer, and these are 6 heavy duty ones, okay? I will tell you guys, there are jack stands, the little trailer stabilizer jacks that you guys can get installed. It was like a $110 option. I did not go for that. I didn't really need it. I can definitely see if you're dropping this trailer off for lawn care or snow, it does make sense to have those there because you can't take a mower in and out of the trailer unless it's hooked up to a truck. So those do make sense. Looking back on it, maybe for $100 I could have sprung for it, but honestly, it's never really been an issue, so I haven't really missed it. If something changes otherwise, I'll let you guys know. These right here, you guys can see that you have really thick, heavy duty rubber seals. I really like that. The metal ramp is integrated into the trailer. All the wood, I can take it out. You can tell that there's different sections and different pieces. You have the heavy duty steel transition flap. By the way, my trailer can sell any of this stuff and mail it to you guys. So if you're out of state or you're looking for any of these things, even as options, they can sell them to you guys. All right, guys, let's look at the inside. So my trailer did come with what they call the gridiron style racks. Now, if I would have knew that we were going to get upgraded with all these stuff from Equipment Defender, honestly, I never would have got the gridiron. But nonetheless, that's how the trailer came, so I just paid for it. And actually, a couple of you guys were asking about where's the gridiron stuff now. Another guy named David actually has it on his trailer. He's somebody who watches our channel. He asked, hey, can I have it? And you know what? I'm not really one of those people that advocate questions like that. But I said, dude, where do you live? He lived about 15 minutes outside of the place where I was vacationing to. And my wife and I brought him to him. So shout out to my man, David. I got to meet him. Really cool dude. He's been watching our channel for a while now. And I said, dude, between Craigslist and eBay, I don't really have the time to put them all up there. So here, you can just have them, okay? So that was probably $250, $300 later. Didn't ask a dime for it. Hopefully I can bless the guy and he can have some more fun with his business. This right here, the spare tire bracket and obviously the tire. This is a $295 upgrade from what I understand. I've got my little sell sheet here that I found for the trailer. Let's see what else I can give you guys. The front cabinets. Now, don't quote me on the pricing here. I think this was about $350, something like that. I think it says $525 as a sell thing on the a little sell sheet on the website for the new inventory for the trailer. I'm not sure what I paid for it, guys. Maybe $350 to $500. But I wanted to get it because I wanted to store all my equipment and I didn't want it sliding around. I didn't have time knowing that I was picking up the trailer mid-season to build shelves and racks. Honestly, I'm a handy kind of guy. I understand how to do certain things, but other things I don't. So I didn't want to be dicking around building shelves. I know a lot of guys have some great videos on those, like Jason Ambro and Beach River Landscape. Me personally, guys, I just didn't have the time or energy, especially with dealing with the season, okay? Now, this trailer does have the cross bracing going through the side walls, which is, I think, an option as well. But to me, it was just kind of a no-brainer. I wanted the most rigidity I could get in the trailer. The heavy-duty workbench, they used to have a steel one. This is an old sell sheet. They said it was $450. I don't think I paid $450 for this guy. This was probably a $250 upgrade. I wanted it hardcore. I've tinkered on it tons. I know it always looks clean. I will tell you guys, the gas can rack holders were about $75 each. As you guys know, we have two of those with the Shurcan gas cans in them. Now, we do have the two dome lights and the two air vents on top. Of course, you get a lot of breeze with the cross breeze going through the trailer, so I like that. And then the only other option, guys, I had was the D-rings that were installed. These were probably, I don't know, maybe $10 or $25 each. I can't even remember, but I know it wasn't too crazy. The only other thing that I was going to mention to you guys was the E-track floor. And the E-track goes all the way down the sides, all the way around through the middle, and then through the back. The E-track is a system, as you guys know, where you can take the like the tie-down straps that have the buckles on both sides, and you can transition it in all different ways for all the different equipment you have in your trailer. If I was a larger outfit and I had 4, 5, 6 guys, or multiple crews and multiple mowers or tasks, yeah, I would definitely spring for the E-track. I think it's $14 a foot installed. So again, if you have a 16-foot long trailer or an 18-foot long trailer, that can add up to another $400 or $500 option. However, I think that's a good investment if you have multiple crews and multiple rigs, multiple mowers and aerators and different things you're using it for, besides the D-rings, because I measured my stuff out knowing what I'm gonna be putting in my trailer. But the E-track, there is a little bit more flexibility to it. For me personally, I just wanted to save the $500 in the meantime. I didn't really see that much of a benefit for my business being a solo owner operator kind of guy, but I can see you being a larger outfit, transporting different materials or pallets of salt. Yeah, the E-track is definitely gonna be a nice upgrade for you guys. The only other way, from what I understand, that you could really spend more money on a trailer like this is making it longer, which is obvious. This is an 8.5 by 16. And by the way, one of the reasons I wanted to go with the 16 footer is because I was only gonna be fitting at most in the future 2 mowers in this thing. That's if I buy a second lawnmower. But right now, all I have is my Exmark Laser Z, and then I also have the stand-on aerator. Now, I'll tell you guys transparently, putting both of those in here, I haven't done it yet because the truck I have is only a 150. This trailer weighs like 3,200 pounds without anything in it. So right now, I'm probably at about 5 or 6, maybe 7,000 pounds. I'd say probably more like in the 5 and 6 range. My 150, it pulls this thing pretty well, but I don't want to overload it, and I don't want to burn up the tranny. And I know a lot of you guys keep commenting about that, and I appreciate that. But nonetheless, I think this is a trailer that my truck could pull no problem for the business setup that I currently have with one mower in it and just my basic hand tools. But the only other way you could have spent more money on this trailer, from what I understand, is if you made it longer. Again, I went with the 8.5 by 16 because when I'm in residential subdivisions, there's only so much space that you guys have between houses. You guys know what I mean? Like between driveway to driveway, there's only so much stuff that I can pull in front of where there's a fire hydrant or a driveway or a sidewalk, and you don't want to be blocking people in like that. Secondly, when you go around cul-de-sacs, the larger the trailer, the harder it is to navigate those cul-de-sacs. And of course, people in cul-de-sacs utilize the cul-de-sacs like you guys wouldn't imagine by parking their cars in the street. Hey, it's their sub, it's where they live, they have every right to do that. But for me as a business owner, I can't navigate through those cul-de-sacs by having cars in the way. So that's why I went with the smaller size trailer. A couple other things I wanted to mention. I know some of the larger companies, Brightview and Brickman, they get the largest trailers, man, the 20 footers, the 24 footers. And I know they install a gas tank systems in there with the pump. I think that's the coolest option ever. If you're cutting huge HOAs and huge commercial properties and hospitals and stuff like that, yeah, you're gonna need the extra gas, more than just gas cans. And I think that's the coolest thing ever, man. I don't know what that price option is, but I do know that some trailers include that. I'm pretty sure you can get that installed on the SureTrack trailers. That's something that you guys gotta look into a little bit more. And then the only other thing I was gonna mention that I wish was an upgrade that I don't believe is available for SureTrack, and maybe they can evaluate making this an option on the future models, is having that side door that you can refuel your mower through. One of the guys I really enjoy watching his videos is Nickens Landscape. His side wall on his trailer has a little cutout basically right here on the side of his trailer, and then that's just a door. And what he can do is feed the gas nozzle in from the gas station and bring it right through and put it in right to his lawnmower. How cool is that? If SureTrack would have added that as an option, that would have been an easy upsell for darn sure, because who doesn't want to not have to deal with taking their lawnmower in and out of the trailer to refuel it at a gas station? It's a little inconvenient. Who really cares? I've never really felt like it was a breaking point with buying the trailer. But if that was an option, oh my God, I absolutely would have sprung for that. I don't care if it would have been $500. Upsell it hardcore. I would have been more than willing to pay that money just on the convenience factor alone. So I'm trying to think what else I can give you guys on the trailer. Again, here's the heavy duty spring. You guys can see with the cables, it works very nice. You got 3/4 inch plywood floors. Actually, let me go underneath the trailer and I'll show you guys the difference with our trailer and how we have the bracing versus some of the trailers that have it like every 2 feet. All right, guys, now I'm not sure if you can see this that well. I'm not sure how the video is gonna look, but this right here, you can see we have the metal cross bracing like every 18 inches, probably 12 inches underneath here. Most trailers don't have that. Most trailers, it's like every 24 inches. You can just see the floor sag. I've seen some guys do videos on that. It's just a pain in the butt. This right here, man, we have so much cross bracing that I don't care how much weight you put in these trailers, that floor is not gonna flex. All right, guys, so that's pretty much it. I know there's a lot of different things that you guys probably had questions on. Hopefully this video helped you out a little bit more. Again, so far I've been ecstatic about the trailer. I don't really have anything to complain about it. And I'm not just being a positive guy when I say stuff like that. Guys, I'm telling you like a friend, I was in the market for this trailer for about 3 years. I'm telling you guys like a friend, there's a lot of other trailer brands out there that I have access to. Being right off of two major highways and in Michigan and being major camp kind of places, there's so many trailer vendors around here. And I'm not putting down any of the other ones. And I'll tell you guys like a friend, this one is definitely the Cadillac in my opinion. This trailer right here was $9,977 with all the options and everything that I picked up with it. Can you definitely spend more money? No doubt about it. Making it longer, adding the E-Track, adding the gas can feature, the gas tank feature, whatever you want to call it. But nonetheless, I didn't want to just get a $5,000 trailer and then have to drop another $2,000 into it or $500 into it by making racks and mounts and all this other stuff. I just wanted something that was nice, it was clean. It was just something that I could pick up and then just transition everything from my utility trailer right to my enclosed trailer and just rock and roll with it, if that makes some sense to you guys. I'll tell you guys like a friend, SureTrack has been absolutely first class with me with dealing with this. I've talked to them. My dealer and I, we have a really good relationship, but we paid retail for this, man. Nobody hooked us up with any incentives or any perks. works. I wish I would have, I wish I could have, but nonetheless, I'm so happy with this investment. Hopefully it helps you guys out. Again, this took me 10 years to get here. It probably only should have took 2 or 3 years if you guys are in the lawn and landscape business to get a trailer like this. I'll do another video on it later on for you guys to talk about the difference between a utility trailer and an enclosed trailer, some of the pros and cons, and maybe that'll be another fun video. If you guys have any specific questions, definitely shoot me a comment down below. I'll be more than happy to answer them the best I can. If you guys enjoyed this video, do me a favor, shoot it a big thumbs up, maybe share it with somebody that's in the lawn care landscaping industry that could benefit from it. If you guys are new to the channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. It means a lot when you guys do that. The channel's blown up and I really appreciate all the support. Nonetheless, guys, if you have any other questions, like I said, leave a comment down below. But again, SureTrack, that's where it's at. If you guys are picking one up, let me know, leave a comment down below. If you did pick one up because of maybe our videos or something like that, also please leave a comment down below. Let me know which one you guys picked up. I'm so jacked if you did. That's so awesome. And I'd love to hear about more of you guys making investments and growing your business and taking things to the next level. All right, guys, that's it from me, Brian's Lawn Maintenance. You guys take care.